Okay, here's the review for acid base. HL Chem review. Let's start with a couple of definitions. And just because it's interesting, the original definition of an acid was a substance with a sour taste. Okay, and remember, bases are bitter. Okay, and the first definition, we're going to start with a three definitions of acids. First one is the Arrhenius. Acid, and this is a substance that produces H plus in solution. And remember, this H plus really exists as the hydronium ion in water. And this, I need to add, this is aqueous solution. Okay, so a Arrhenius base then is a substance that produces hydroxide ion in aqueous solution. Okay, so second definition is going to be the Bronsted-Lowry acid and base. Hi. This is a substance that can donate a proton. Okay, and then a Bronsted-Lowry base is a substance that can accept a proton. Okay. And then the last series of definitions, Lewis acid, is a substance that accepts an electron pair and a Lewis base is going to be a substance that donates. An electron pair. Couple other terms to know. Monoprotic. This is an acid really that has one hydrogen. As an example would be hydrochloric acid. Okay, diprotic. Hopefully you figure that means two. So the example would be like H2SO4. And then you have triprotic, which would be phosphoric acid. A strong acid or base is something that is going to completely ionize or dissociate. And a weak is going to be something that only partially ionizes or dissociates. Another term, conjugate, acid, base pair. Okay. these are going to differ by 1 H. Okay, and if you have a strong acid, you have a weak conjugate base. And this will be something like if I have SO4 negative in water, it can set up an equilibrium and form H2SO4 and hydroxide. This is actually, this first component is acting as a base with its conjugate acid base, conjugate acid here. Water is acting as the acid with its conjugate base being the hydroxide because it's giving up the hydronium ion. Okay, now we could also have this hydrogen sulfate ion in water, and it could form the sulfate ion and the hydronium ion. In that case, this is acting as the acid with this being its conjugate base. Water is now acting as the base with the hydronium acid being its conjugate acid. Substances that can be both acids and bases are said to be amphiprotic or amphoteric. Either word works. Let's take a quick look at the Lewis acids and bases. If we take a look at boron trifluoride, boron trifluoride, if I react this with a fluoride ion, it will go and form this ion. This electron pair donor is the base, Lewis base. Boron trifluoride is the acid because it accepted this Lewis or this electron pair. Remember that the this would also be known as the ligand. And I would make a complex ion. Oh, probably not a complex ion because it's boron. Complex ion should be a transition metal. Sorry about that. Okay. Interesting, if we look at aluminum chloride, remember that aluminum chloride makes that dimer. Okay, if I take two of these and they react, it's going to set up an equilibrium. Chlorine, 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 aluminum, chlorine, sorry, chlorine. But one of these chlorines is the electron pair donor for that aluminum, and this is the electron pair donor for here, and that's that dimer, if you remember from that unit on periodicity. All right, so sidetracked a little bit into complex ions. So let's look at chemistry terms. Okay, so chemistry terms versus normal people. Okay, strong acids and bases really has to do to the degree in which it's ionized. Concentrated is versus dilute really is the molarity or the concentration of the solution. Terms like corrosive really relates to how reactive the acid or the base is. The opposite of reactive would be unreactive. Or inert. Typically, the definition for strong and normal people is the one that differs quite a lot from what we would do. All right, and that ends the first kind of intro screencast.